The automotive industry is going electric, and some brands are going to make the change kicking and screaming. Others want to be more proactive. Volkswagen, while still attempting to put its Dieselgate scandal behind it, is making big claims about its electric future, to the point of saying that this new model, the ID.4, is going to be the face of its brand. So let's see what kind of face that's going to be. This is the first edition of the ID.4, and so with that you get some special exterior details like this illuminated bar across the front that bisects the black and white Volkswagen logo. You also get these LED projector headlights that do this really cool startup when you wake up the vehicle, along with these LED daytime running lights surrounding the headlights. And the whole design of this ID.4 is very simple and clean, and I appreciate that. They didn't try to overdo it and make a big statement. It's supposed to just be a normal car, just happens to be electric. On the side, we get a set of 20-inch alloy wheels that's also part of the first edition package, as is the first badging, and this black contrasting roof. We also see some roof rails up here. The door handles are interesting because, though they are flush mounted, it has the outline of a door handle, but they don't pop open at all. You just put your fingers inside and press up on the tab to unlock the door. Getting to the back, there's a subtle roof-mounted spoiler up here, an LED light bar that runs across the back, just like that LED light bar in the front. ID.4 is in white here, and then down below, you'll notice a tow hitch. Yes, this vehicle can tow just 1,500 pounds. Overall, the ID.4 design is smooth, unfussy. It's a handsome little SUV. Unlike some EVs, the ID.4 doesn't have a front trunk, but you can see some of the powertrain components. We have a single electric motor powering the rear wheels connected to a 77 kilowatt per hour battery pack. It makes 201 horsepower and 229 pound-feet of torque, gets this thing to 60 in 7.6 seconds onto a top speed of 100 miles per hour. The miles per gallon equivalent is 97 and the total range is 250 miles. Inside the ID.4, you get a bunch of standard features like these leatherette seating surfaces with the ID perforated in the seat backs. They're heated and they have a lumbar massage. You also get your own armrest and a heated leather wrapped steering wheel. The white detailing is part of the first edition package that also gives you this single pane, massive panoramic glass roof. That's really cool. The only downside is it doesn't open at all. There's a standard 10.4-inch touchscreen infotainment with wireless Apple CarPlay and wireless Android Auto. I found this to be fairly easy to use, and the graphics are sharp, the colors pop, but there are some times that I wish I had some more physical button redundancies. You do have these capacitive touch hotkeys down here that do help, but some more buttons would be nice. Then in front of the driver is a 5-inch TFT display that's full color, and it has your range information, your speed, and the active safety features you are using. Above that, there's ID light. It's a string of 56 LED lights that interact with you and change color and work with the voice assistant in the vehicle. That's another standard feature. You also have a wireless smartphone charging pad down here, nice big pad, two USB-C ports, and tons of storage in this cabin. Two cup holders up top, and then a large reconfigurable area in here that you can close up and hide your valuables. Large door pockets in there, and even more space in the back. Speaking of, let's go check it out. Getting into the back is real easy thanks to nice wide opening doors and the fact that it doesn't have a sloping roof line. And when you're inside, you can enjoy plenty of space. I've got lots of knee room. There are good sized foot pockets for my feet to slide under, and my head clears the roof. Your amenities, apart from the space, aren't all that much. You do have two USB-C ports and air vents, no third zone of climate control, no heating for these back seats. They don't slide, they don't recline, but you do have a smartphone pocket. That's pretty nice. The overall cabin in this ID.4 is just like the exterior. It's clean, it's contemporary, but there are some harder, cheaper plastics to be found inside. Without a drive shaft, you could easily have a third adult sit back here, but if you don't have someone there, you do have a center console with cup holders and a pass-through for your luggage. There's a substantial 30 cubic feet behind that second row of seating. If you need more, you can push down these tabs and fold the seats fairly easily for a total of 64 cubic feet of space. The seats aren't completely flat, but they're fairly close. And if you need more height, you've got a two-position load floor. It's real simple to get moving in the ID.4. You just hop into the driver's seat, put your foot on the brake, and then either crank the drive selector back to reverse or forward to drive, and you're moving. We have a few drive modes to use in the ID.4, so we're gonna start out in comfort mode. That's gonna be relaxed in terms of throttle response and steering feel and braking response. But what about that suspension? Well, it's not an adaptive suspension, and so I'm noting that the ride quality is a little on the rougher side. Not terrible as a driver, but as a rear seat passenger, my wife and I noted on a long road trip with our daughter in the back, when she sat back there, it was a bit bumpy. But the other dimensions of comfort in the ID.4 are very good. The seats are comfortable, and the wind and road noise is kept at a minimum. Now let's see about the pickup. We're gonna go into sport drive mode now, and put the foot down. All right, so it gets moving. It's not the peppiest of acceleration, and I almost would have expected more from the instant torque that you get from an electric powertrain, but it does get moving. You just have to be a little more patient with it. The ID.4 does come standard with a full suite of driver assistance features, including adaptive cruise control and lane keeping assist. So we'll turn those on right now and let them do their thing, keeping the vehicle centered in the lane very well. This is a good system. Now, Volkswagen is making the bet that people are ready for an all-electric vehicle as long as it has a pretty reasonable range. This vehicle at 250 miles of range is significant. However, the other factor is charging capability and charging speed. So the ID.4 at a DC fast charger will kick up just in 10 minutes, will add 60 miles of range, and it'll go from 5 to 80% in just 38 minutes. If you don't have access to a DC fast charger, as long as you've got a 220 volt outlet, you can charge up the ID.4 overnight. It's worth remembering that the ID.4 is rear-wheel drive, so that when you put your power down out of a corner, it's actually pretty fun. And the steering feel isn't that bad for an all-electric, non-performance vehicle. You have a good sense of what the tires are doing. I am astonished by how good the turning radius is in the ID.4. Here's a very tight turn, and no effort, just nails it. That's so useful in tight spots. Like most EVs, the ID.4 does have regenerative braking, and it's just one level and therefore not a single pedal drive situation, but it's super easy to operate. You just crank forward on the drive selector and now you've got regen braking on. Crank forward once more and now you're back to coasting. Now let's cool things off in custom or eco drive mode so we can talk about competition. The Volkswagen ID.4 starts at about $40,000, excluding a $7,500 federal tax credit. I already mentioned that it has 250 miles of range, and all these features as part of the ID.4 first edition package will bump up the price to about $45,000. Stack that up against two main rivals, the Tesla Model Y. The Y starts at $41,000, and it has 244 miles of range, but there is, for $51,000, a long-range version with 326 miles of range. Then we've got the Ford Mustang Mach-E. That one starts at $44,000. It has 230 miles of range, but there is a long-range version of that for $48,000 that has 306 miles of range. So the ID.4 with its $40,000 starting figure before that $7,500 tax credit that the Tesla Model Y can't access and 250 miles of range is very compelling. I like how it looks. The cabin is fairly comfortable and the tech is pretty darn good. The only thing that draws me back on it is that ride quality, which is fairly firm. If you want to learn more about any of the vehicles I mentioned in this review, click the link in the description below or go to automotive.com. Thanks for watching.